Hey Wando, if you're a freshman, sophomore, or junior, pay close attention to this next video because it's going to show you how to choose your electives for next year.
Hey Miss Gatlin, I heard you could help me sign up for some electives this year.
Hey Tate, I sure can.
First, we need to enter the world of Power School.
Here we are in Power School.
Wow, I should come here more often.
You should, you should. So Tate, to sign up for your electives, the first thing we need to do is look at your IGP. Your counselor has entered your core classes. So let's click right over here in IGP Success Viewer. So here it is. So it looks like you have how many core classes signed up for next year, 12th grade?
I believe that's five.
Five. So you can take up to eight classes. So you can sign up for how many electives?
Three.
Three. Yep.
Math.
So let's exit out of this and go back to class registration, which is just right over here. So once you're in class registration, it's pretty simple. All you do is select the pencil button. Your classes that you have to choose from are in alphabetical order and pick any electives you'd like. And then you have to select two alternates just down at the bottom, and then you hit submit and the classes you've registered for are there. So that's it. Your elective requests for next year have been saved.
Radical.
In order to start the registration process, you will need to log into PowerSchool with your username and password.
If you don't have a PowerSchool account, come by the Media Center and set up your username and password.
Starting March 7th, juniors will have the whole week to select electives. The following week, which is March 14th, sophomores will have the whole week.
Freshmen will request their electives April 25th through April 29th. For any freshmen who have not had their IGP meeting prior to April 25th, they can lock their electives in during their IGP meeting instead.
If you signed up for a Trident dual credit course, a high school equivalent is also in your IGP success planner. Once you turn in your qualifying test scores plus your dual credit application, the high school course will be removed. If you do not turn in your application and your qualifying test scores by June 1st, the dual credit course will be removed and the high school equivalent will remain.
Classes that require an audition you will not need to select will select those for you.
If you would like to make changes to your core requests or your electives after the registration window closes, you can submit a schedule change form with a parent or guardian signature by June 1st.
So make sure you check the program of studies at wandohigh.com for any of the prereqs or course descriptions that you may need. But don't worry about being in a hurry. If you need a few days to sign up during the week of your portal open, that your portal is open, you have plenty of time to do that. Also consult your counselor and you have up through June 1st to make any changes.
Be sure to choose your courses wisely since you will not be able to change them after June 1st. Also, before you can complete the process, you must choose two alternate courses. Thank you.
Need help? Come see us in the school counseling office Monday, March 7th from 4 to 7, or Monday, March 14th, or Monday, April 25th for any help you may need with the registration process.
Hey Wando, I'm Tommy Fairbairn, and welcome to your favorite school news show, Tribe Talk. This week, we're going to take a look at dreams coming true, big names merging, and an update on our nation's politics. But first, Violet West hits the street just to find out how really trustworthy your classmates are.
It's important for students to be able to trust their peers. We're here today to see just how trustworthy Wando students are with a game based on the prisoner's dilemma.
You can either choose to split, so you'll both get candy, or one of you can steal, and if one steals, then they get all the candy. But if you both choose to steal, then no one gets anything. Do you trust her?
Yeah.
You?
No.
Okay, write your answer on the board, and don't show anyone.
Okay.
On the count of three, show the camera. 1, 2, 3. You both get candy.
Okay, on the count of three, show 1, 2, 3. You both get candy.
One, two, three.
Oh my god!
Why is she stealing?
We're not friends anymore.
A lot, because I'm a winner.
Good luck, guys. You both need candy!
Walking into the school store, have you ever thought about more than that soda you just bought? MC McCarthy gets behind the counter to report.
Many Wando students know where the school store is, but who runs it? Is it a class? Where does all the money go? Today, we take a look inside the Warrior Shop.
Ms. Beckham, she said she wanted a school store that promoted Wando spirit in the community, which we really didn't have a lot of. You barely could find a Wando t-shirt, hat, anything 10 years ago.
The school store is called School Store Internship, and to get into it you have to take marketing and management as a prerequisite.
The student-run store offers real-world experience to those working behind the counter.
Mr. Belkey is our manager. He goes out and buys the food, you know, supplies runs and stuff, and we like sell it and tell them what we need.
The school store is hands-on learning. Sometimes they wonder, what am I actually doing in here? What am I actually learning? But things like work ethic and initiative, they learn to think on their own. Critical thinking skills are what we try and key in on the most.
When it gets really busy, it sometimes backs up, so we gotta make sure that we're efficient and quick and help our customers as fast as we can.
With the frequent exchange of money, students often express curiosity as to where the money goes.
It does not go in my pocket like a lot of people think. Every dollar that we make goes back to the school or the community in some form or fashion.
It goes to fund DECA, which is like our business club, and also it goes to FBLA, and also we have to constantly restock our goods.
Recently, Charleston County passed regulation to set new nutrition standards.
It was a lot of hard work to get new inventory, know what the guidelines were.
We used to be able to sell basically anything we wanted. It could be regular soft drinks and any candy, but some regulations change what we sell, so we have more healthy options, like we got some good dried fruit.
Mr. Belkey helps the students maintain working goals to better prepare them for the future.
If I end up having a job like this, and I'll be like prepared for it, and I can put it on my resume for colleges and more jobs that I work for a school store.
I plan on majoring in business and doing sales once I get out of college, so it's a good kind of first experience.
This has been MC McCarthy reporting for Tribe Talk.
Mount Pleasant Swim Club and Live to Play Swim Team are two of the best swim teams in the Low Country. Recently, they announced that they would be merging to create one team called the South Carolina Swim Club.
I think it's a phenomenal opportunity to create an excellent club here in Charleston.
It's pretty exciting because these are two of the top four teams in the state.
I'm excited for it. It'll be a really, really big change, but I think it'll be really good for both teams.
It was a bit of a shock, to be honest, at first. There had always been questions and rumors about, what if these two teams got together, we could really create, this incredible large team.
We're concerned about some hostilities between the two teams, especially with some of the older kids.
There's questions about whether there'll be the same culture and the same feeling for each team that will be preserved.
Although the merge is a great opportunity for both teams, they'll be saying goodbye to current head coaches Benji DeMont and Jessup Zadowski.
The head coaches of both teams, LTP and MPSC, are actually both leaving the area.
I think without Benji and Jessup, merging might be a little bit easier, even because you won't be able to stay attached to them.
As a major perk for the new team, the nationally renowned Pam Swander will be joining SCSC as their new head coach.
She comes from Swim Mac. It was her team that won Junior Nationals in December, and she comes with a whole lot of experience.
I've known Coach Pam for a number of years. She's one of the most respected coaches in the country.
She seems like she's got a lot of experience and be good for the team.
This would be a huge deal for Wando. You're going to have higher performance swimmers now entering the program.
I'm very proud of what we've been able to accomplish here as a team separately, and I think together is just going to be something magical for not only the sport of swimming, but you know, very specifically for Charleston area swimming. I think it's great.
This has been Jenna Sulkowski reporting for Tribe Talk.
Prom's right around the corner, but with it, so are the expenses. A North Charleston program offers people who are in less fortunate circumstances still have the royal night out.
Every girl should feel special on her prom night, and thanks to Cinderella Day, every girl can.
Cinderella Day is really an event that's so much more than just coming to get a prom dress. It's a day that we can create a moment in a girl's life where they can feel beautiful and loved.
I think I got involved in Cinderella Day just years ago when I would volunteer for everything, and they asked me one day to help, so I came in, and it was just a cool experience to help girls find dresses and watch how happy they were when they found the dress.
Cinderella Day would not be possible without the help of the community.
In regards to hair and makeup, Paul Mitchell, the school comes and they provide all of the hair and makeup stylists. There actually really is not a requirement to participate. We are here to serve girls who, you know, may not have the financial means to get what they need for prom. The way we obtain our dresses is solely on donations. So we've been extremely blessed by the community. We've received just an outpouring of dress donations, and we've also been so fortunate to have a couple of organizations and companies actually donate brand new dresses.
I think Cinderella Day has helped me, or kind of like JC said, outreaching with the community, and it kind of brought a realization that many girls can't really afford so much of dresses.
There was a moment last year where I kind of walked out of the doors of our dress boutique where we, you know, have all of our personal shoppers, and that goes out into our outdoor space, which is where we have a huge white tent set up out there. It's where we have our live music and our DJ, and that's where the hair and makeup is done. And I walked outside and the music was going, and there was just a huge group of girls and their moms and just all these people just dancing and just having fun. And that's really what this is all about, is just having a really fun, memorable day.
Come join us Saturday, March 5th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the North Charleston Dream Center. This has been Logan Swinford reporting for Tribe Talk.
Baby, yeah. because this isn't just a class, this is my family. I love all of these people, and this is just amazing. So everyone should sign up for Intro Dance at their Spring IGP.
It affects thousands of teens every year.
It makes you want to cry.
It makes you never want to get out of bed.
It crushes your soul.
Some people think it's not a problem.
It's a serious problem.
It's not a big deal until it happens to you.
We need to act now.
There is no cure.
You can't run from it.
Felt like a stray.
The shame was that I'm growing up without parents, that I'm growing up in a children's home, that I'm in a foster home. It's not what's considered normal. So part of the shame was that I was carrying was what my mom, who my mom and dad were, because who they are is what makes me who I am. I actually grew up in a group home from the time I was 9. But prior to that, I was in foster care, in and out a little bit from the time I was a baby, and then entered into a group home when I was 9, and then went back into a foster home when I was 16. So pretty much my whole childhood, I was under somebody else's care. The promise was that my mom was gonna come back. Clock starts ticking and the months start passing, and you start to realize that maybe she's not coming back. And I remember I used to lie when the kids would say, "Where do you live?" And I'd make up a story, like, and then they'd say, "What do your parents do?" And I would just lie about it. The moment I became an orphan was the moment I felt like one. And you attach the stigma to yourself that something's wrong with me, that I'm not important. You just want to fit in like everybody else. But what's hard is that even when you're smiling during the day and trying to make the best of the situation, when your head hits the pillow at night, you're crying yourself to sleep because you just want to be home. I think if teenagers really could just stop trying to focus so much on trying to fit in with everybody else, and they would actually step out and be the one that would include the person that sits by themselves at lunch. Most people in your school probably don't even know which kids are growing up in group homes, which kids are in foster care, because the truth is we're all people. But we're all struggling. Find people that will build you up, and they're out there. And my challenge is for those in the school that that are growing up with a stable family to be a light and to be an encouragement to the kids that, you know, that are growing up in single parent homes or in foster care.
Hi, Wanda. This is Riley Biller on this week's Sports Talk. A big congratulations to our boys soccer team for defeating the number 2 team in the nation in Jail Man. Also, congrats to our boys and girls lacrosse teams for both winning their season openers. The girls beat Hiltonhead 17-0, and the boys beat Fort Mill 15-5. Also this week, there are home soccer games on Friday. The girls at 5:30 and the boys at 7.
What is hardcourt bike polo?
Bike polo is a 3-on-3 sport where it gets a lot of its roots from hockey. It's played on a rink with 4 walls, 2 goals. There is no permanent goalie. It's pretty much at first started with a free-for-all to get the ball in the goal. It's developed into what I would consider a professional sport that now has a full guideline of rules. Definitely a contact sport. You're allowed to check anything shoulder to shoulder as long as you are in possession of the ball or hitting the person with the ball is legal. Bike polo started as a sport in Washington State. A few bike messengers simply got bored in between delivering packages in the winter. They got a few ski poles and some gas pipe, made the first mallets out of, you know, DIY stuff. They played with hockey balls and they just went under an overpass and got some traffic cones to make a goal. That's where it started. I was riding my bike around downtown Charleston, happened to run into one of the players, and since then I've gone every single meeting Charleston's had except for the year I was living in Florida.
Myself and probably about 7 or 8 other people went to Pensacola, Florida for a bike race in 2009, I believe in like February 2009. And that was my first exposure to bike polo.
A lot of people are wowed by it, confused, and most people say that they can't play because it's simply too complicated, but really it's just like riding a bike. Words of advice on getting started is don't get frustrated. It is hard to at first ride completely one-handed and keep your eye focused on the ball.
Like I said, I really love bike polo, so I'd rather try hard and fail and just not try and also fail.
For more information, go to leagueofbikepolo.com. This has been Blake Ellis reporting for Tribe Talk.
Thanks for watching, Wando, and stick around for Tribe Talk Presents. This has been Tommy Fairbairn, signing off. Up again.
said, if you don't want it trapped, then your mind won't you let it be. Never should've told ya. Never should've let you see inside. If you don't want it trapped, then your mind won't you let it be.
Stake. I never thought your love was worth its weight. Well, now you've come and gone.